faithful to you because of the word of God that lives and abides forever.
Baba wa dupe lowo yin fun oro yin eyi to ye to si wa titi
lai lai. The world may pass, but your word remains unchanging, unchangeable, unmovable forever.
Aye yi yo koja lo sugbon oro yin o duro titi a o le yi pada o a o le dogbon si titi lai lai.
And it's only those who abide in your word who will abide forever when the world has passed away and forgotten.
Gbogbo kiki gbogbo awon ti o ba tele oro yin nikan to nge nu oro yin awon na ni o wa ti ayiraye nigba ti aye ba ti koja lo ta ti gbagbe re.
The only guarantee we have of abiding forever is to abide in your word, abide in your will, abide in your way.
Ohun kan na to le fi wa lokan bale nigba ta wa ni pe ka wa ninu oro yin ninu ite yin ati ninu ona yin.
Praying Father that every one of us, no matter who we are, you help us to line up our lives with your word, with your will, and have the assurance that whatever may happen here on earth, there in eternity, we will abide forever.
Mo n gbadura pe enikan kan wa ti a wa nbi gbogbo erongba aye wa a fi ni kegbe kegbe pelu ife yin pelu oro yin pelu ete yin ohun to le ma sele ni aye ye ati ti aye
raye. Wherever the will of man clashes with the will of God, help us to choose your will and push aside our own will or any other will, because therein lies our joy.
Angbadura nibi ti ife eniyan to ti tapo ife ero olorun ife olorun ena wa lo lati le gba ife yin to pe nu eleyi ni ayo wa
wa. I pray, Lord, that every member of this church, every worshipper today, if we have nothing else, help us to have this assurance that we abide in the will of God.
Baba mo ngbadura fun gbogbo olujo si ni ojo eni ye ba jo ngbogbo lo ba te ro ba jo ngbogbo lo abe ni dan loju pe a ngbe ninu oro yin ni gbogbo aye wa.
And whatever it costs us to abide in that will, help us to pay the price in Jesus' name.
Ohun kan ti o ba si na wa lati le ma gbe ninu ife yin ye ena wa lati san ye na loruko Jesu.
We're praying for all those who might have confusions in any area of their lives. By your word and your will, clear every confusion, restore joy to every heart in Jesus' name.
Mo gbadura fun gbogbo awon to ni poru ni igbesi aye won. Gbogbo iporuru na nipasẹ oro yin emu kuro ke si da ayo pada sinu aye won loruko Jesu.
Thank you for the answer.
Adupe fun idahun.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu la gbadura.
Amen.
Amen.
In Psalm 40 and verse 5.
Ninu orin Davidi ori ogoji ese karun.
And whenever we come to church, it's we have two choices to make.
Igbakugba ta ba wa ti ni si church.
It's either to submit to the control of the Lord and the Spirit of God to guide us and allow God to give us everything He has in mind so that we go home full, loaded with His blessings.
Yala, ki a ti gba oro Olorun, ki a ti gba ibukun na, ki a farabalẹ, ki a gbo gbore ninu ni ekun re t'Olorun yo fi fun wa ka to ma lo le.
I said we allow God to control us, and He just decides and He takes everything and He brings out His own program, and then at the end of the day we are fully loaded with His blessing.
Ohun ti mo so na ni wi pe a o gba Olorun laaye lati dari wa ko le raye ninu wa ko ba le fun anekun rere ibukun.
On the other hand, we could make a choice of controlling the Spirit of God, directing the Spirit of God, choosing for the Spirit of God what we should have and what we shouldn't have, how long we should spend and how long we shouldn't spend, and then He leaves us to make all the choices, and then He's not able to load us with all the benefits for the day. We go back home as dry as we came. Those are the two choices we have.
Ni dakeji na a le fe mo se akoso emi Olorun ka ma diwon akoko ta olo fun iwa so oro Olorun o na ti a o se ta ba ni ru wa ti ibi eleyin ko gbogbo ibuku to won fe di ru wa ni ojo na a o ni le gba lo ka to lo le.
I counsel everyone to pick the first choice. Allow the Spirit of God to just control our hearts and minds and everything and give us everything He has in mind for today.
Mo gba wa niyanju pe abala akoko yen o ni ki a gba ki agba emi Olorun laaye lati se akoso kan wa lati akoso ero wa ka le gbe to dara.
I pray your life will be transformed today in Jesus' name.
Mo gbadura pe Oluwa yo ye aye re pada loni loruko Jesu.
The message this morning is on the will of the Lord.
Iwaasu ti owuro ye o ni ife ti Oluwa.
The will of the Lord. In Psalm 40 and verse 5. Here you find the psalmist speaking and glorifying God for what God has done for him.
It is Psalm
of David. And he looked back. At the time he had problems. And he prayed unto God. God answered his prayer. He was in a pit. Out of the miry clay, the Lord brought him out. He says, God has put a new song in my mouth. And in fact, what God has done for me is so evident that every man and woman who has eyes can see. He summarized everything in verse 5 and he said, many. O Lord, my God, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done. He was saying that I look at the things that you have done in my life. I look at the blessings. I look at your protection. I look at your goodness. I look at everything you have done for me, and I cannot even finish counting. I just say, many are thy works, wonderful works unto me which thou hast done, O Lord.
Oh, wongu wati Olorun ti se iseun Olorun ibukun Olorun iranlowo Olorun o na o le o koja ntenu so pe emi wo ise iyanu gbogbo ti iwo ti nse.
And he says, thy thoughts which are to us what, there are so many, they cannot be reckoned up in order unto thee.
O si wi pe ati ero inu re ti ipa ti wa a ko le ka won fo ni esese.
He said, in fact, if I will declare them, name them one by one, counting my blessings, and I want to speak of them, they are more than can be numbered.
O ni temi o ba ma ka lesese ni okokan lati so nipa awon ibukun Olorun o jo nti a le fenu so lo.
And then the psalmist says,
Olorun David,
the natural reaction you will expect from a man who sees the goodness of the Lord, the faithfulness of the Lord, the blessings of the Lord, the many, many things God has done, the natural reaction will be for that individual to bring offerings and sacrifices unto God.
Is
to bring thanks offerings unto God. And praise, worship, and adoration, and thanksgiving, and sacrifice, and offering, and burnt offering. Bring everything to the Lord. But he says, God is not man. That the response of gratitude that God expects from those who have received great things from him, it's not even the sacrifice, it's not even the offering. He says, it is the opening of their ears unto the word, the law of God.
Verse 6,
sacrifice and offering thou didst not desire, my ears thou hast opened, burnt offerings and sin offering thou hast not required. Then said I, lo, I come, in the volume of the book it is written of me, I delight to do thy will, O my God, yea, thy law is within my heart.
Ese ikepa, ebo ati ore iwo ko fe, eti mi ni iwo ti si, ore ebo sisun ati ore ebo ese, o ni ko bere, nigba na ni mo wi pe, kiyesi emi de, ninu apo iwe ni ni agbeko iwe mi pe, inu mi dun lati se ife re, Olorun mi, ni tooto ofin re nbe ni aya mi.
Oh, he says the gratitude God desires, the gratitude God demands from those who have got blessings from God, it's not the sacrifice, it's not the offering. What does he want? He opens your ears to teach you his will, to teach you his word, and then he wants you to show delight in doing that will of God in your life. That is the offering, that is the sacrifice God delights in and he demands from you. He's telling us here now that you might bring offering, money, sacrifice, gift, and everything to God. That's okay. But beyond that, above that, God will be looking for something in your life, whoever you are, preacher, pastor, worker, member, sinner, whatever, is looking for you to make sure that above all the money you give, above all the offering you give, he wants to be sure in your life you are right inside the will of God.
Ohun ti Olorun to dumo Olorun ninu ju o na ni pe yelo je omo ijo o je osise o je olusogun ton o na ni pe ki o gba Olorun laye se
It's like God is telling us that what the people in the world do, he doesn't appreciate it. He says, you bring all your offerings to God. You bring all the sacrifices to God. But all the while you are doing that, your heart is not surrendering to that will of that same God.
And
that although they are giving gifts to God, they are still keeping their will. He says he doesn't need the sacrifices and offerings. That will there's not. You don't desire it. God says, I don't want it. I don't need all the offering and the burnt offering and the sin offering. Thou hast not required. God doesn't need all that. What does he need? He wants to see that you delight in his will, you delight in his ways, you delight in his choice, and you follow it with all your heart. That's the truth that is hidden in Romans chapter 12. In Romans chapter 12, you see in verse 2 over there, that truth is hidden somewhere. In verse 1, he says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service.
He's
telling us here, bring all your sacrifice to God. By all means, bring them. Bring all your offerings and sacrifices unto the Lord. Bring your service, bring everything, bring all you can offer to God. But he says, while you are doing that, make sure that you don't conform to this world. What does it mean? Do not be conformed to this world.
It's
saying that the way they do it in the world is that when they give offering to God, when they give sacrifices to God, they expect God to accept that and close his eyes to their self-will. Close his eyes to their choosing their own way. Close his eyes to their rejection of his purpose. That God, I've given you all the money you want, so leave me now to do whatever I want. He says, be not conformed to this world.
So he says,
don't do like that. But be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Prove, demonstrate what is the good and acceptable and the perfect will of God in your life. What
he's
telling us that God does not surrender his lordship in your life in exchange for your giving, your sacrifices, your offerings that you do for him. In spite of all your offerings, in spite of your sacrifices, after all the things that you have given, God still wants to be Lord, sovereign in your life, whose will must prevail above your own will, prove the perfect will of God. He tells us three things in that verse 2. Number 1, he tells us imitation. Number 2, he tells us transformation. Number 3, he tells us demonstration. And then demonstration. Imitation, he says, don't imitate the people, the godless world. Don't conform to this world in your offering, in your sacrifices. Simply put, that is telling you that don't be like the people of the world who think that all God needs is their money, all God needs is their sacrifice, all God needs is their offerings. After that, they can go ahead and keep their own will and do whatever they like. After all, God, I gave you what you wanted.
Táwọn gbà wí pé tán bá ti fi ọrẹ wọn fún Ọlọ́run, owó wọn fún Ọlọ́run, ìrúbọ fún Ọlọ́run, àwọn lè máa pa ìfẹ́ nú ara wọn mọ́ Ọlọ́run tó ṣàbẹ̀rẹ̀ mọ́ ṣàkùn ti fi fún ọ.
No, he says you have to be transformed.
Oníbẹ̀ẹ̀kọ́ ẹ parada.
That's why I say you have to be patient this morning because you need transformation in your mind.
Ìdí tí mo fi sọ pé gbọ́dọ̀ ní sùúrù lówùúrọ̀ yìí nìyí torí pé ẹ nílò ìyípadà nínú èrò inú yín.
And that transformation will now lead to a demonstration of God's will in your life.
Ìyípadà tẹ́ ẹ bá ní ìyípadà nǹkan yóò wá lọ sí àfihàn ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ayé yín.
This you will prove, you will demonstrate, you will show what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Ó ní ẹ ó rí ẹ ó fi sójú ṣe ìdí ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run tó dára tó ṣe ìtẹ́wọ́gbà tó sì pé.
In these days as we speak of ICC money contribution and everything, the Lord wants you to know that after you have given all the gifts, after you have given all the offering, after you have given all the sacrifices and the money and everything, that is not an exchange for God's lordship in your life. He must still be Lord and his will must still prevail.
O sọ fún wa báyìí nípa bá ṣe sọ nípa gbọ̀ngàn àpérò ICC, a ń kó owó jọ, a ń mú ẹ̀bùn wá, a mú iṣẹ́ ìsìn wá wá, a ń ṣe gbogbo rẹ̀. Ọlọ́run wí pé lẹ́yìn ìgbà tá a bá ṣe eléyè, ìjólúwọ Ọlọ́run nínú ayé wa àti pé ká tẹríba fún Ọlọ́run nínú ohun gbogbo, a gbọ́dọ̀ ṣe pàṣípàrọ̀ rẹ̀.
He requests you to seek his will.
Ó ń retí yín kí ẹ wá ìfẹ́ rẹ̀.
Find out his will.
Kẹ́ ẹ wádìí ìdí ìfẹ́
rẹ̀. And do that will on the day-to-day issues that arise in your life.
Kí ẹ máa fi ìdí ìfẹ́ yẹn kẹ́ máa fi múlẹ̀ nínú ohun gbogbo tó ń ṣẹlẹ̀ lóòrèkóòrè nínú ayé yín.
That's why he says you have to prove it.
Ó ní kẹ́ ẹ fi hàn.
Don't say, well, after all, I've given to God my living sacrifice, I've given to God my reasonable service, and therefore now whatever remains after that belongs to me. No, he says he's still the Lord. He must still have the dominion in your life.
O ma se wi pe ohun ti Olorun bere ebo aye ebo irubo mi o mo ti fi fun Olorun sugbon sibe ohun ta n so ni wi pe leyin to ti se nkan wonye Olorun fe ma se akoso gege bi Oluwa ninu aye re.
We live in days when men and women are impatient to find out the will of God.
Awon ojo ta n gbe wonye o awon eniyan lokunrin lobirin won je lai ni suru lati wadi kini ife Olorun gan.
They just go ahead and do as occasion serves them.
Won tesi waju bi igba ti gba lodo won na se nse.
And when they do that, what does that mean? Does that mean there is no will behind their actions, their decisions? Does that mean there is no will controlling the steps they take in their lives? Yes, there is one will, but what will is it?
Nígbà tó ń bá ṣe irú nǹkan báyìí, ìbéèrè náà dé o. Ṣé kò sí ìfẹ́ inú ìfẹ́ kan tó ń ṣe àkóso nǹkan wọ̀nyí? Lóòótọ́ nǹkan wà tó jẹ́ tó wà ní kúlẹ̀kúlẹ̀.
And in John chapter 1, he tells us the wills that you know lie under the actions and decisions of men and women.
Níjọ́ àná orí kìíní, ó sọ fún wa àwọn tó máa ń jẹ́ ìlépa ọkàn, èròǹgbà ọkàn lẹ́nu ohun gbogbo téèyàn bá ń gbé ṣe.
And whichever of these determines that controls your life, whichever of these three will bend your life here on earth, might even determine your end in eternity.
Ìkan nínú àwọn nǹkan tá a máa sọ wọ̀nyí tó jẹ́ ìfẹ́ tó ń darí ẹni wọ̀nyí tó bá ń ṣàkóso àwọn ìṣesí tirẹ̀ yóò tẹ ayé rẹ ti ayérayé.
In verse 12, he had been talking about those who are sons of God.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì lọ́wọ́ sọ nípa àwọn tí ń ṣe ọmọ Ọlọ́run.
Then in verse 13, John chapter 1, they were born not of blood, that means not naturally, nor of the will of the flesh, that's one, nor of the will of man, that's two, but of God.
Ó ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹta ló wá sọ àwọn ẹni tí a bí kìí ṣe nípa ti ìfẹ́ ènìyàn ti àkọ́kọ́ nìyẹn ti ẹ̀jẹ̀ kìí ṣe nípa ilé ìta obì bá ṣe ń bí mọ tàbí nípa ìfẹ́ ti ara ìkejì nìyẹn tàbí kìí ṣe nípa ìfẹ́ ti ènìyàn ìkẹta nìyẹn.
You have to be asking yourself every day.
Máa bi ara ẹ lẹ́yìn lójoojúmọ́.
The steps that I take.
Àwọn ìgbésẹ̀ tí mò ń gbé.
The actions that I put up.
Àwọn tí mò ń fi sójú ṣe.
The decisions that I take.
Ìpinnu tí mò ń ṣe.
What lies behind it? What will lies behind it?
Ipa wo ló wà lẹ́yìn rẹ̀?
No, will, that means the decision, the purpose, the resolve that lies behind the action.
Kí ló ń tó jẹ́ òrè okùnfà rẹ̀? Ohun tó wà nínú rẹ̀ tó fi ń ṣe.
That is, you find out from yourself.
Bí ara rẹ léèrè.
What resolve is in my heart when I made that decision? What a decision, what determination do I have when I took that step? You know, in my heart, you find out, is it the will of the flesh, the will of man, or the will of God?
Wádi, kí ni kúlẹ̀kúlẹ̀ náà? Ohun tó tì ọ́ gan kó tó ṣe ìfẹ́ inú tó mú kó ṣe nǹkan náà. Ṣé ti ara ni tàbí ti ẹ̀jẹ̀ ni tàbí ti ènìyàn?
He tells us the will of the flesh.
Ó sọ nípa ìfẹ́ ti ara.
Well, in 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 2.
Ní Pétérù kìíní orí kẹrin ẹsẹ̀ kejì.
We will find an explanation of that, the will of the flesh.
A ó rí àlàyé ńbẹ ìfẹ́ ti ara.
And you see that it's always in contrast to the will of God.
Ó rí pé ìgbàgbọ́ ló máa ń ṣe lòdì sí ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
In 1 Peter 4 verse 2.
Pétérù kìíní orí kẹrin ẹsẹ̀ kejì.
That he should no longer that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lusts or desires of men, but to the will of God.
Kí ẹ̀yin kí ó máa ṣe fi ìgbà ayé yín yòókù wà nínú ara mọ́ nínú ìfẹ́ ènìyàn lábẹ́ ìṣàkóso ènìyàn sí ìfẹ́kúfẹ́ ènìyàn bí kò ṣe sí ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
What he's telling us is that your flesh has its own desires.
Ohun tó ń sọ fún ni pé ẹran ara rẹ ní àwọn àfẹ́rìtì rẹ.
Your flesh has its own wishes.
Àwọn ẹran ara rẹ ó ní àwọn nǹkan tó ń náà fẹ́.
Your flesh has its own choices.
Ó ní àwọn yíyan ti rẹ.
Your flesh has its own determination.
Àní ẹran ara rẹ náà ó ní ìpinnu tara rẹ.
And that represents the will of your flesh.
Eléyìí gan ló ń sọ nípa ìfẹ́ ti ara rẹ.
Yes, if you are going to be born again.
Ohun tó bá di àtúnbí.
It's not going to be by the will of the flesh.
Kò ní jẹ́ nípa ìfẹ́ ti ara.
Because the flesh never likes to be born again.
Ara ò fẹ́ kóhun di àtúnbí.
The flesh never likes to forsake sin.
Ara ò fẹ́ kó ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ sí.
But if you are going to be born again, the will of the flesh must be set aside. And you will not live your life to the lusts of the flesh. It will not be the things the flesh wants that you will do. After you are even born again, the tendency is still there for you to do the will of your flesh. And at that moment you are doing the will of your flesh, you cannot at the same time be doing the will of God.
Nígbà yẹn tó ń ṣe ìfẹ́ ti ara, o lè máa ṣe ìfẹ́ ti Ọlọ́run lẹ́ẹ̀kan náà.
The two are always in opposition to one another.
Méjèèjì ló lòdì sí ara wọn.
The will of the flesh.
Ìfẹ́ ti ara.
I think we'll be talking more, but look at number two now, the will of man.
Ìkejì báyìí ìfẹ́ ti ènìyàn wo.
Here it tells us that some people live their lives, they take their decisions, they put up their actions by the will of man.
Ó sọ fún wa pé àwọn kan wà, wọ́n ń gbé ìgbésí ayé wọn. Wọ́n ṣe ìpinnu wọn, wọ́n gbé ìgbésẹ̀ wọn gẹ́gẹ́ bí nípa ìfẹ́ ti ènìyàn.
That is, there are men and women in your life.
Ipe àwọn ènìyàn kan bẹ nínú ayé gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọkùnrin àti obìnrin.
Who wield great influence in their life.
Àwọn tó ní ipa tó gbogbo nínú ayé rẹ.
Those men may be their husbands.
Àwọn ènìyàn yẹn lè jẹ́ ọkọ yín.
Those men may be their women, may be their wives.
Obìnrin náà lè jẹ́ aya yín.
Maybe a friend.
Ó lè jẹ́ ọ̀rẹ́.
Maybe a boss.
Ó lè jẹ́ ọ̀gá ilé-iṣẹ́.
Maybe a co-worker.
Ó lè jẹ́ ẹni tí ẹ jọ ń ṣiṣẹ́ náà.
Maybe a relative.
Ó lè jẹ́ aráalé.
But that man, although he's just a man, he wields so much influence in your life, and everything you do, every step you take, every action you put up is by the will of that man, not the will of God.
Ó ní ète fún ọ ní àwọn nǹkan kan tó yẹ pé wo bá ti ń ṣe ó dà yálà ọkùnrin tàbí obìnrin ìgbésẹ̀ tó ń gbé yẹn ó ní ipa lórí rẹ̀ ọ̀nà tiẹ̀ ló fẹ́ kó tẹ̀ sí.
And it says that if that man is going to work with God, if you are going to please God, you will not be taking your decisions, you will not be going in the direction as dictated by the will of man.
Ó ní tó bá wá ní nípa ti ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run ó ní máa ṣe ìpinnu rẹ ó ní máa gbé ìgbésẹ̀ rẹ ìwàsí rẹ ó ní ṣe gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìfẹ́ ènìyàn.
Not your own will.
Kì í ṣe ìfẹ́ tara rẹ.
Not the will of man.
Kì í ṣe ìfẹ́ ti ènìyàn.
But by the will of God.
Ṣùgbọ́n nípa ìfẹ́ ti Ọlọ́run.
The will of God in his capacity as the Lord of your life.
Ó ṣe ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run nínú ipa rẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí olúwa ayé rẹ.
The will of God in his capacity as the sovereign one in your life.
Ìfẹ́ ti Ọlọ́run nínú ipa rẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹni tó jẹ gàba lórí rẹ.
What is the reason for so much failure in Christian lives today?
Kí ni ìdíjọ́ ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìkùnà tó wà nígbèsí ayé Kristẹni lónìí?
What is the reason for so much stand still in many Christian lives today?
Kí ni ìdí tí ìdúró ti rí tó wà nígbèsí ayé ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ Kristẹni lónìí?
What is the reason behind the dryness in many Christian lives today?
Kí ló fà á tí ipò gbígbẹ nípa ti ẹ̀mí bẹ ní ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ayé Kristẹni?
What is the reason for so much darkness, spiritual darkness in Christian lives today?
Kí ló fà á tí òkùnkùn ti ẹ̀mí fi wà nígbèsí ayé ìgbàgbọ́ lónìí?
Why is it that there seems to be open closed heavens upon so many lives?
Ṣé tó fi dàbí pé ọ̀run la ṣe mọ́ nínú ayé ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ènìyàn?
Well, it's because many times steps are taken, decisions are done, the things that are done are by the will of the flesh, by the will of man, not by the will of God. They never take time to find out the will of God in that matter.
Ìdí náà ni pé ní ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìgbà àwọn ìpinnu táwọn èèyàn ń gbé, àwọn ìgbésẹ̀ tí wọ́n ń gbé, àwọn tó ń fi sójú ṣe, ó wà yálà nípa ti ara tàbí ìfẹ́ tipa ti ènìyàn, kì í ṣe nípa ti ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run. Wọn ò tilẹ̀ bìkítà láti wádìí kí ni ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run lórí òun náà kan tó gbé ìgbésẹ̀.
The faster you find out the will of God in your journey to heaven, the easier the journey becomes.
Kíákíá tó bá wádìí ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run nínú ìrìnàjò rẹ sí ìlú ọ̀run, bẹ́ẹ̀ ló ṣe máa rọ̀ Ọlọ́run tó.
We forfeit so much peace because we forsake the will of God.
À ń pàdánù ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ àlàáfíà torí pé a kọ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run sílẹ̀.
We forfeit so much confidence in prayer because we forfeit the will of God. We forfeit so much boldness before demons because we forsake the will of God.
We
have an erosion of authority in the Lord because we have abandoned the will of God. And until we go back and find out what is the will of God, the will of God, the will of the Lord in various issues that arise in our
life,
we cannot speed forward in the journey to heaven. But today the Lord is telling us, whatever we give, whatever we become, whatever we do, whatever the sacrifice and the offering, whatever the money, whatever the service, whatever the commitment we give to the Lord, we still have the duty of discovering and doing on a daily basis the will of the Lord. We have 3 points here. Before we go to those 3 points,
can
I please tell you this? When we talk about the will of the Lord, you know the will of man is the man himself. That is the controlling center. All the thoughts of that man, the ways of that man, the decisions of that man, the steps that man takes, the will lies behind everything. And when we're talking about the will of the Lord, it means the way of the Lord. It means the word of the Lord. It means the decision of the Lord. There are many people who have forfeited the peace of God in their hearts because they have forsaken the will of the Lord in their lives. They have cast it aside. And the Lord is saying, come back. Come back to the center of that will of God. Come back to the center of the word of God. Come back to the center of the mind, the way, and the wisdom of God. As long as you cast aside the will of God in your life for that long, for that much, you will remain in misery and trouble. That's why it's important. As we go back to the Lord today, find out the will of the Lord. Point number one, seeking God's will in prayer. Point number one, I said, seeking God's will in prayer. And then point number two, submission to God's will and program. Submission to God's will and program. And then number three, standing fast in God's will and purpose. Standing fast in God's will and purpose. We go back to point number one. And in Romans chapter 12, and in verse 2, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove, that you may discover, that you may demonstrate, that you may do. You see that word proved there, very, very pregnant. It means you discover it. It means you do it. It means you demonstrate it. That good, perfect, acceptable will of God.
If you
walk with God, if you will grow in grace, if you will rid yourself of so much heartache in your life, in fact, if you will get to heaven at last, you must come to a point in your life
where
you get rid of that impatience, the pressure that drives you, that urges you on to commit yourself to a thing, a person, a decision, without first finding out the will of the Lord about it.
Oh, no, don't you look on pon, lati fi ara re ji fun ohun kan tabi fun enikan tabi fun ipinu kan lai koko wa di fi Olorun.
You must get to that point in your life. When you put aside all that urge, all that pressure that makes you to commit yourself to something, commit yourself to a situation, a decision, or an individual without first finding out what is the will of the Lord, you must get to a point in your life when you long to pray like David in Psalm 143 verse 10.
O ye ko de gogo kan nu aye re e to ko lati mo gbadura bi David ni orin David ogoje ole meta ese kewa.
Psalm 143 verse 10.
Orin David meta le logoje ese kewa.
Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy spirit is good. Lead me into the land of uprightness.
Ko mi lati se ohun ti o wu o nitori won ni Olorun mi.
Find out in many lives. When last did they pray about this kind of prayer? Find out in many Christian lives. When last did they take time to pray, teach me to do your will, O Lord? Find out in your own life. When last did it matter to you whether it is the will of God or it's not?
But
David said, although I'm a king,
David,
and yet, Lord, I do have many decisions to take. Teach me to do thy will. Lead me in the way that is good. This is a prayer that is important. It's a prayer that is the key to the joy of many lives. It's the prayer that provides the key to success in your life.
It's
a prayer that provides the key to growth in your Christian life.
It's
a prayer that provides the key, the walking stick that you will walk with God thereby. But because many times we are put aside that, and we forfeit so many good things, the Lord is calling us by, says, go back and find out the will of the Lord. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 17 says, wherefore be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is.
Oni ni tori na ma se alailoye sugbe ma mo ye ohun ti ife Oluwa ja si.
Many believers nowadays are so clever. Very intelligent. And our intelligence many times is our problem. Our knowledge many times is our problem. Our experience many times is our problem. The experience that we should not be unwise, but we should be wise. Finding out what the will of the Lord is. You think about Moses. Think about his walk with God.
And
find out that a time came in his life. He failed to find out what the will of the Lord is. Of course, you know what happened. He couldn't get to Canaan. Although God told him what his will was, but Moses did not do it. He did his own will.
And
the Lord is warning you and me. Don't be unwise. Find out what the will of the Lord is. And in your life, don't say, well, I've given to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, I've given to God what belongs to God, the rest belongs to me. No, he wants all of you, your money, your riches, everything you give, contribution, gift, and after that, he still wants you to lay your will at his feet, and he wants to still control you, control your life. You never get to a point in your life.
Oh, God,
I've given so much to God.
committed so much to God. I consecrated so much to God. And now the rest belongs to me. No, you must still submit to His will. Talking about the will of God, there are two types. Number one, there is the revealed will of God. Number two is the unrevealed will of God. The will of God that has been revealed in Scripture. These are general to every one of us. And it is a major, major, major thing in the will of God. It is a fundamental thing in the will of God. Because it affects time and eternity. The revealed will of God is a major thing. But two, there is the unrevealed will of God. The revealed will of God, you'll find it out in the Word. The unrevealed will of God, you'll find it out in prayer. But these ones that have been revealed are so important, are so major, so very important, that eternity depends on them. Now let me take some time with you on this revealed will of God. In 1 Timothy chapter 2. 1 Timothy chapter 2. And in verse 1. And it says, I exhort therefore that first of all, supplications, prayers, intercessions, giving of thanks be made for all men. For kings and for all that are in authority, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior. Who will have all men to be saved and to come unto the knowledge of the truth? So he tells us here that the one of the will of God revealed that we know, given to us, is that it is the will of God that all men be saved. That's the will of God. And no matter who you are, no matter the sin you have committed, no matter the evil that you have done, I have good news for you today. It is the will of God for you to be saved. He has not given up on you. No matter the evil you have done, the grace of God, the mercy of God, it reaches you, even you. God wants you to be saved. It is the will of God for you to be saved. If you are not saved, therefore, the world is telling you today, you must be saved. God doesn't want you to die in your sin. He wants you to be saved. He wants you to be born again. Maybe you might say, I've done so much evil. I don't think God can forgive somebody like me. God says you are the candidate He wants. He wants you to be saved. He's not willing that you should perish. But He wants you to come to the knowledge, to repentance, to salvation. Then He tells us also that it is the will of God that we come to the knowledge of the truth. That means spiritual knowledge grounded in the truth of the Word of God is the will of God. God places no premium on ignorance. You know, God doesn't like ignorance. It's the will of God that you come to the knowledge of the truth. You know, there are places where they don't preach the truth. And they even abuse us in deeper lies. They say, too much Bible. you. Too much preaching. Too much teaching. Well, because it is the will of God that the church will come to the knowledge of the truth. Unfortunately, many people in this church don't like the truth also. We prefer places where they put on due emphasis on one thing, one truth of scripture. Just take one strand of truth and emphasize it and beat it and beat it and build the whole denomination on it.
They
may be fasting. And they build the whole denomination on fasting.
It
may be on demonology. And they build the whole denomination on demonology.
God
says he wants us to come to the balanced knowledge of the truth of the word of God.
They
are the ignorant ones, we are the knowledgeable ones, because we seek out the word of God, every part of scripture, not just one truth, and then we build the whole doctrine on that.
It's
the will of God. If you don't like this kind of a church where you are taught in the word of God, it's very unfortunate.
So
you say, is preaching we're going to have again? Teaching again. Retreat. Is it the word of God we're going to hear again? You are like the Israelites. They got manna every day. Until they got fed up with that manna. And they began to despise the manna in the sight of God.
And
you know God didn't like that. Why are we deeper life people becoming like this? Like we have so much the word of God, we don't learn from scripture.
Well,
are we despising the manna that comes from heaven? Don't you know it's the will of God for you to come to knowledge, balanced knowledge of the word of God? That's why we teach and teach and preach and preach, because we want to abide in the will of God. The reason God has blessed this church so much is because the leadership has decided to abide in the will of God, teaching the truth of the word of God to the people of God.
In
1 Thessalonians 4:3. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that you should abstain from fornication. Of course, he tells us very clearly there. One of the revealed will of God is that you should have sanctification. That means cleanliness, holiness. And then in verse 4, he says that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel, his bodily members, in sanctification and honor. And then he says, not in the laws of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God. Then after he has rounded off everything in verse 7, he gives us the summary. He says, because God has not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. Why are you joining critics against your own church? And you are ashamed of the holiness message. These modern churches outside, they ridicule the message of holiness. And you too, you get involved in all that, you ridicule the message of holiness. Don't you realize that holiness and sanctification is one of the revealed will of God?
And
if it's the will of God, you better make sure that it is done in your life.
It says,
this is the will of God. Your sanctification. Your cleanliness. Your righteousness. Your holiness. Tell me then, if any church or any denomination or any preacher, if anyone who handles the Bible stands up and by direct speaking, by implication, by illustration, he or she ridicules the holiness message, is that church in the will of God then?
Well, so for me, Bobadi and Nikon, Oniwa Sukon, Ijokon, Nipa, Nipa, Koni, Nipa, Nipa, Kwan, Yawa, Nipa, and Kati, one shade on Fion. Àti àwọn àfiwé wọn tó wá fẹnu ṣáta ìwà mi ìwà bí ọlọ́run ṣé ẹni tí ọlọ́run lẹni yẹn.
And you say, well, don't you see, pastor, they are increasing number.
O wá wípé olùṣọ́-àgùntàn o wá rí pé wọ́n ń pọ̀ ní tiwọn.
Pastor, don't you see so many of them.
Christ Jesus concerning you.
Ẹ máa dúpẹ́ nínú ohun gbogbo nítorí èyí ni ìfẹ́ ọlọ́run nínú Kristi Jésù fún yín.
I'm sad. Life has gone bad for me. My desires have not been met. My expectation has been disappointed. In everything, give thanks. This is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you.
Oh, so pe inu mi baje, inu mi odun. Gbogbo ilepa mi o ti ja si otubante. Gbogbo ti mo foju lona fun o ja si pabo. Bibeli wi pe ninu ohun gbogbo e ma dupe tori eji ni ife Olorun ni Kristi fun yin.
It doesn't matter whether you are happy doing it or not. In everything, give thanks. Is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you.
O ja mo nkankan boya inu re dun nigba to ndupe lowo Olorun tabi be ko o ni e ma dupe ninu ohun gbogbo o leyi ni ife Olorun ni Kristi fun yin.
The will of God, you better make sure you are doing it in your life.
Bo ba je ife Olorun o je ri pe o nse nu aye re.
First Peter chapter 2.
Peteru kini ori keji.
In verse 11.
Ese kokonla.
You I'm looking at you are together with you on the revealed will of God.
Mo ba yin wo papo ninpa ife Olorun ta fi han.
In First Peter chapter 2 verse 11.
Peteru kini ori keji ese kokonla.
Dearly beloved, I beseech you as strangers and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts which were against the soul.
Olufe mo be yin bi alejo ati bi ero. Láti fàṣẹ́yìn kúrò ní ìfẹ́kúfẹ́ ara ti ń bá ọkàn jagun.
Having your conversation honest among the Gentiles, that whereas they speak against you as evil doers, they may, by your good works, which they shall behold, glorify God in the day of visitation.
Kí ìwà yín láàárín àwọn kẹfẹ̀rí kí ó dára, pé bí wọ́n ti ń sọ̀rọ̀ yín ní bí olùṣẹ́lú búburú, nípa iṣẹ́ rere yín tí wọ́n ó máa kíyèsí, kí wọ́n kí ó lè máa yan Ọlọ́run lógo ní ọjọ́ ìbẹ̀wò.
Then in verse 15, it sums it up.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ kẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́dógún wá sọ papọ̀.
Because, for it is the will of God that with well doing you may put to silence the ignorance of foolish men.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́dógún bẹ́ẹ̀ sáà ni ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run pé ní rere ṣe kẹ́ẹ̀ẹ́ kí o lè dáhùn pé àwọn wèrè ènìyàn lẹ́kùn.
What he's saying here is that it doesn't matter what the people of the world are talking about.
Ohun tó ń sọ ni kò já mọ́ kankan ohun tí àwọn ará ayé ń sọ.
They may speak good about you.
Wọ́n lè sọ rere nípa rẹ.
They may speak bad about you.
Wọ́n lè sọ burú nípa rẹ.
But one thing is the will of God.
Ohun kan ni o ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
You live such a blameless life before them.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ìgbésí ayé tí ò lábùkù níwájú wọn.
Live such a righteous life before them.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ìgbésí ayé òdodo níwájú wọn.
That your life will put to silence the ignorance of foolish men and women.
Kí ayé rẹ kí ó lè dé kó lè pa àwọn òpè ènìyàn lẹ́nu mọ́.
It means that as a Christian.
O sọ pé ẹ bí Kristẹni.
What God is looking for in your life.
O sọ lọ́run wá nínú ayé rẹ.
That is his will for you.
Tó jẹ́ ìfẹ́ rẹ̀ fún ọ.
Is that you do well.
Kó o máa ṣe rere.
You live well.
O máa gbé dáadáa.
And by your life, sinners cannot speak against the gospel.
Àti nípa ìgbésí ayé rẹ, àwọn ẹlẹ́ṣẹ̀ wọn ò ní máa sọ lòlì sí ìrere.
If we leave all this aside.
Bàbá kọ ògbélé ìṣẹ́gbẹ́
kan. And we're running after shadows that is not the will of God.
Sọ wá ń sáré tó òjìjì lẹ́yìn tí kìí ṣe ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
I don't know the will of God for your life.
Mi ò wá mọ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ayé rẹ o.
You don't know the will of God for my life.
Mi ò mọ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ayé mi.
You don't know the will of God for my life.
Ìwọ ò mọ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ayé mi.
But these ones are the will of God for every one of us, no exception.
Ṣùgbọ́n àwọn eléyìí tá a ti kà wọ̀nyé ní í ṣe ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún gbogbo wa láàyò ẹnìkan sí.
Are you saved from sin?
Ṣé a ti gbà ọ́ lọ́wọ́ ẹ̀ṣẹ̀?
If you are not saved from sin, you must be saved today because it's the will of God.
Bó o bá ti rí gbàdà kó inú ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ èyí lọ́jọ́ ìgbàlà rẹ ó jẹ́ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run.
Are you growing in spiritual knowledge?
Ṣé o ń dàgbà nínú ìgbà ìmọ̀ ti ẹ̀mí?
If you are not, that's the will of God for you.
Bó o bá ti mọ dàgbà nípa ti ẹ̀mí inú ìmọ̀ Ọlọ́run ó jẹ́ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ọ.
Are you sanctified and having a holy heart, a holy life?
Ṣé a ti sọ di mímọ́? Ṣé o ní ọkàn pópón ìgbésí ayé mímọ́?
The will of God for you wherever you may be.
Ẹni tó wù kò jẹ́ eléyìí ní ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ọ.
No matter how dirty your environment may be.
Bí àyíká rẹ ṣe lè dọ̀tí tó.
This is the will of God, your sanctification.
Ìsọdi mímọ́ yìí o ní ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run fún ọ.
Are you giving thanks to God? Do you have a thankful spirit in all circumstances?
Ṣé ìwọ ń dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ Ọlọ́run? Ṣé o lẹ́mìí ìdúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ Ọlọ́run ní gbogbo àyídáyìdá ayé rẹ?
That's the will of God.
Ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run ni yìí.
Are you living a blameless life, righteous conduct?
That's the will of God. Those ones have been revealed. But there is the unrevealed will of God. These are secondary. They affect time only. They don't affect eternity. And that's why whatever the unrevealed will of God for your life, you must be subservient to that one that has been revealed in the word of God. The unrevealed will of God for you must never contradict his will already revealed in scripture.
If you
and those things that you need, you may not know the will of God about, you need to pray about. There are issues of life, marriage, choice of friends, choice of career, choice of habitation, and all those mundane issues of life. There are things you don't know directly from scripture, the will of God about them, you have to pray about them. And they must never be allowed to tamper with the revealed will of God. And yet there are believers. In fact, there are even churches that are built majorly, they major on this unrevealed will of God. And they abandoned the revealed will of God. They center on issues that, are minor issues. On marriage. On vision. On dreams. On prophecy. And when they do that, they look on us and deeper life. They look down on us. They say, you people, you don't know anything. You only stay with the Bible. You don't know anything. Your eyes are not open. Friend, those things you are majoring on, they are the minor things. The ones that are major are the ones God has revealed in the scripture. You are the ignorant one. Majoring on minor issues. The revealed will of God is the most important of it all. Because it touches your eternity where you will spend eternity with God. Why must you seek that will of God?
Number one,
it is the basis of divine relationship. Number two, the basis of divine revelation. Number three, the basis of divine favor. Number four, it is the basis of divine response. Number five is the basis of a strong faith. Number six is the guarantee of admittance into heaven. In Matthew chapter 12 and verse 50. And of course, these are the words of Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother. This is the basis of divine relationship. If you want relationship with Christ the Lord, then you will make sure you remain, you abide in the center of the will of God every day of your life. Then you are his brother. Then you are the brother of Christ, the sister of Christ. He even said, I own such people as my mother. That was when he was in the world. John chapter 7 and verse 17 is the basis of divine revelation. And it says, if any man will do his will, he shall know of the doctrine, whether it be of God or whether I speak of myself.
What's
the reason for so much darkness in many lives today? Why are many people praying and they seem not to be able to find out the will of God? Why is it that they don't know of the doctrine of the guidance of the Lord? Why is it that Christ cannot teach them? He cannot reveal himself to them. Because the Lord looks into their hearts and
he
sees that they are not interested in doing his will. They want to do their own will. Therefore, he will not reveal himself to them. If any man will do his will, then he shall know of the doctrine.
Then
number 3 is the basis of divine favor. In Acts chapter 13 verse 22. And it says, when he had removed him, he raised up unto them David to be their king, to whom also he gave testimony and said, I have found David, listen to this, very important, I have found David the son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, which shall fulfill, how many? All my
will.
God removed Saul from the throne. He was a king, but God rejected him. Because he would not do the will of God. He had his own will every time. Self-will removes you from the book of God's favor. I don't want that man. I found another man. David, the son of
Jesse,
a man after my own heart. Why do I find him a man like that?
Well,
he does my will. All the will of God. I pray God will find you. As one of those doing the will of God. That's why you have not got your ministry yet. That's why you have not found your usefulness yet. That's why you have not reached your fullest potentials yet. That's why God has not broken through in your life yet. It's because you have not started, you have not got a heart that wants to fulfill all the will of God. All, no exception.
So is
the basis of divine response. John chapter 9 verse 31. Now, we know that God hears not sinners. But if any man be a worshipper of God and doeth his will, him he heareth. In many churches today, they will pray to God.
But
how many of those prayers will God hear? Number one, the sinners, they will cry. God will not hear their cry. Number two, there are worshippers, religious worshippers, who go to church regularly, but their wills are never conquered. Their wills are never given to God. They have their own will very strong in their heart. The Bible says when they don't do the will of God, God will not hear them. It's the basis of divine response.
Five
is the basis of strong faith.
First
John chapter 5 verse 14.
First John 5:14,
you know what he says? We know, we have the confidence that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us.
When you look at your
life, and there's a problem right now, and you see, I am in the will of God. I'm not doing my own will. I know that right now, I'm in the center of the will of God.
Put
confidence in your heart in prayer. That gives you boldness to approach the throne of grace.
And
says, God, this is according to your will.
And
you have the confidence confidence when you are praying, you are sure God will hear you.
It's
the basis for a strong faith in God. It's important that you are in the will of God in your life. And finally, it's the basis, the guarantee of your being admitted into heaven. Of course, I've read Matthew chapter 7, but still open it. Matthew 7:21. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. You may check up in your life.
Why did you find out
that you are not submitting to the will of God? Jesus says that might even shut up heaven against you. And unless you decide, and you make up your mind, and you surrender to the will of God, until then, certainty of getting to heaven is not on your hand.
He that doeth
the will of my Father.
Whether
revealed will or unrevealed will, the will of my Father. Nowadays, you find deeper life people, sanctification is not important to many of them again. A holy heart, a holy mind is not important to them again. The gospel of holiness and sanctification is not important to them again. Now is the gospel of fasting. The gospel of prayer. The gospel of, 7 days and 21 days and 42 days fasting. The gospel of casting out demons, the demon in the mouth, the vehicle, the demon in the pocket, the demon in the backyard, the demon in the ceiling, the demon under the ground, the demon in the farm, the demon in everywhere. That's the gospel they carried about now.
That's
the will of God.
If you
are doing the will of God from the heart, that is the important thing that will get you to heaven. And you must submit to that will of God. Matthew chapter 6. We go to point number 2. Submission to God's will and program. Jesus taught us to pray. In verse 9, after this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. That's the Lord's prayer. In some lives, it sounds differently. The Father which art in heaven, how are you over there? Welcome to my kingdom. My will is done in it, and yours is done in heaven. That's their own Lord's prayer. Welcome to my kingdom. Not thy kingdom come, but you are welcome to my kingdom. And in that, my kingdom, my will is done in it, as yours is done in your heaven. But Christ taught us to pray, thy will be done. And himself demonstrated that in his life. Matthew chapter 26. Verse 39. You know what Jesus said? He went before the Father. The will of God was so heavy. It was like a bitter cup for him. But he said, Lord, not as I will, but as thou will. And in verse 42 again, he went away again the second time, and he prayed, saying, oh my Father, if this cup may not pass away from me except I drink it, thy will be done. Submission to the will of God. Whether it crosses your own will, or it agrees with your own will, submission to the will of God.
Now,
when Jesus taught us to pray, thy will be done. Number one, it is not the bitter surrender surrender to a wicked sovereign, wicked king.
That's
it. Well, since this you are a wicked king and that's what you want, anyway, your will be done.
Oh, wa wipe ah nigba to je oba buburu ko buru na ife eni ka se.
No, it's a cheerful surrender.
Oh, ntan o je yonda
eni. A willing surrender.
Ko dinu eni wa.
A complete surrender of your heart and mind.
Ni yonda parapata okan re ati ero re.
Oh Lord, let your will be done.
O tin wipe Oluwa ki ife re je.
In my life, let your will be done.
Ninu aye mi ife re
je. In my situation, let your will be done.
Iko ti mo wa yi je ki ife re je.
In my family, let your will be done.
Ninu ebi mi ife re je.
In my business, let your will be done.
Ninu oko owo mi ife re je.
In my difficulties, let your will be done.
Ninu awon eni.
In my successes, let your will be done. When I'm joyful, let your will be done. When I'm sad, let your will be done. When I'm making progress, let your will be done. When there's a standstill, let your will be done. Not a bitter surrender to a wicked sovereign. Number two, it is not the passive resignation of a lazy fellow.
A
prayerless fellow. A scriptureless fellow.
And then
he says, well, number two, I said, it's not the passive resignation of a lazy fellow.
When
we are saying submit to the will of God,
I'm
not saying that you then say, well, anything God will do, whether I pray or not, it will happen.
Oh, wani wipe ohun to ba wu Olorun na Olorun yo kuku se boya mo gbadura bi mi gbadura ohun to ma se na ni o sele.
Hey, that was what Eli. You see, when the message went to him, tell your children they are not doing well. Otherwise, I'll bring judgment upon you.
Okay.
He said, he is the Lord now. Let him do whatever he wants. That's not submitting to the will of God. Number three, it is not a theology of confusion. Of the Calvinists. The people that say, well, God has destined everything. Whether I pray or not, who has resisted his will? That they say, well, there's a destiny. And well, that's the will of God. And if it is evil, that's the will of God. If it is death, that's the will of God. If it is failure, that's the will of God.
I'm
not talking when it says, thy will be done. It is not a theological confusion that says, God has destined what will be, it will be. Whether I pray or not, nobody can change it. No, it's saying that when it says thy will be done, it's telling us that you find out what the will of the Lord is, and immediately you discover that will of God, you submit to it, thy will be done. Many times it is our friends that hinder us from doing the will of God. Many times our friends are our enemies. Our well-wishers are our enemies. Several times. In Acts chapter 21 verse 10. And as we tarried there many days, there came down from Judea a certain prophet named Agabus. And when he was come unto us, he took Paul's girdle and bound his own hands and feet and said, thus says the Holy Ghost, so shall the Jews at Jerusalem bind the man that owneth this girdle, and they shall deliver him into the hands of the Gentiles.
Nígbà tó ti di ọ̀dọ̀ wa, ó mọ̀ mùrè Paul, ó sì di ara ẹ̀ ní ọwọ́ àwọn ẹsẹ̀, ó sì wí pé, báyìí ni ẹ̀mí mímọ́ wí, báyìí ni àwọn Jews tó wà ní Jerusalem yóò di ọkùnrin tó ni àmùrè yé, wọn ó sì filé àwọn kèfèrí lọ́wọ́.
And when we had these things, both we and they of that place, we besought him not to go up to Jerusalem.
Nígbà tí àwa sì ti gbọ́ nǹkan wọ̀nyí, àti àwa àti àwọn ará ibẹ̀ náà bẹ̀ pé kí ó má ṣe gòkè lọ sí Jerusalem.
Then Paul answered, what mean ye to weep and to break my heart? I'm not ready to be bound only, but also to die at Jerusalem for the name of the Lord Jesus. When it will not be persuaded, we ceased saying, the will of the Lord be done.
Nígbà náà ni Paul dáhùn wípé, ewon eyin se yi te yin tin so kun te tin mu ore ba okan mi nitori emi mura tan ki se fun dide nikan sugbon lati ku pelu ni Jerusalem nitori oruko Jesu Oluwa nigba ti a ko le pa ni okan da awa dake wi pe ife ti Oluwa ni ki a se.
These people knew that it was the will of the Lord.
Awon won yin mo pe o je ife ti Oluwa.
God had told Paul.
Olorun ti so fun Paul.
He was witness in Jerusalem.
Yo je ri ni Jerusalem.
God had told Paul.
Olorun ti so fun Paul.
He was stand before Caesar.
Yo do oriwaju Kesari.
And now the prophet came.
Woli wa de baye.
He said that Jerusalem you are going there.
Oni Jerusalem yen o nlo be
baye. And instead of these people submitting to the will of God.
He
started to cry, shedding tears, trying to persuade this man out of the will of God.
They
loved him, but they were his enemies. How many times is like that with many of us? This is the will of God for you. But your mother somewhere, your father somewhere, your friend somewhere, maybe even a spiritual leader somewhere, or somebody who just is a well wisher for you somewhere. And then he will stand.
Yo, and
will be crying and be persuading you against the will of the Lord.
Yo, man,
instead of being like Paul,
and
said, no, I submit to that program. I submit to that will of God.
We're
not like Paul many times. We allow those tears and those words to make us to cast aside the will of God, and we cast aside at the same time the favor of God. Paul said, why are you crying? I know the will of God and I'm going to do it. Because after he persuaded the people, that they now said, okay, the will of the Lord it is, let it be done. What's the will of the Lord? Have you taken time to even find it out? Do you stand with it no matter who is happy, who is not happy? The will of God may agree with your own will. Otherwise, it may cross your own will. But whether it agrees with your will or not, it is still the will of God. It must be done. Don't follow a Christianity of convenience. If the will of God agrees with my own will, I do it. If it crosses my will, I throw it out. You will forfeit so much blessing when you do like that. You will forfeit so much joy if you do like that. You must find out what is the will of God. Stand with it. Never change. Never move. No matter what anybody may say. No matter the persuasion. No matter the words of men. You stand steadfastly in that will of God. That was a prayer that man was praying for his convert. In Colossians chapter 4. And that brings us to point number 3. Standing fast in God's will and purpose. In Colossians chapter 4 verse 12. Colossians chapter 4 and verse 12. Epaphras, who is one of you, a servant of Christ, saluted you, always laboring fervently for you in prayers, that ye may stand perfect and complete in all the will of God. Listen, there are so many winds that are ready to blow you out of the will of God. So many temptations ready to swerve you out of the will of God. So many agents of the devil standing outside there wanting to pull you out of the will of God.
But
like Epaphras, I'm praying for you. Laboring for you in prayer.
That
you particularly will stand perfect and complete in all the will of God.
Because
I know, if you don't abide in the will of God, heaven is not sure. Of course, the will of God may be bitter sometimes. Of course, it may be bitter. It was bitter for Jesus Christ. But he stayed there. He stayed there. The will of God may be bitter. Maybe like a bitter leaf that you have to eat. But it's the will of God all the same. It may be difficult for the flesh. But it's the will of God all the same. It may be hard for you as a man. But it's the will of God all the same. I'm praying for you. You will not be blown out of the will of God. You will not be swept out of the will of God. Where can you find joy? Where can you find peace? Where can you find fulfillment? Where can you find a meaningful life? Outside the will of God? Never. It's only when you are in the center of the will of God. Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews chapter 10. And verse 35. Cast not away therefore your confidence, which has great recompense of reward.
For you
have need of patience, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. There's a promise ahead of you. A promise of victory. A promise of joy. A promise of answer to prayer. A promice of fulfillment in life. A promise of abundant progress and promotion. A promise of promotion. Even a promise of heaven. But after you have done the will of God, you need to be patient in that will of God. And wait in the will of God. Don't run ahead of God. There are some of you are running ahead of God. Be patient. Don't run ahead of God. It says you have need of patience. After you have done the will of God, everything like this. My life like this? Why is my situation like this? Why is my circumstance like this? I have done the will of God. Why is it that things are not the way it should be in my life? I've done the will of God. Why is it that I'm not seeing what I want to see? I've done the will of God. Why is it that it's like I'm in darkness? Well, the Bible says, be patient. After you have done the will of God, there's a promise for you to inherit. And it's in Isaiah chapter 50. Isaiah chapter 50, verse 10, deep truth. In verse 10, Isaiah chapter 50. Please pay attention as I read this verse. Maybe this is one of the last verses I'm going to read, but pay attention. Isaiah 50, verse 10. Who is among you that fears the Lord, that obeys the voice of his servants, that walks in darkness and has no light? Let him trust in the name of the Lord and stay upon his God. Sometimes when you are in the will of God, it's like you are in darkness. You fear the Lord, no doubt. You are obeying the voice of his servant, no doubt. But yet it's like you are in darkness. It's like you have no light. This is the will of God. Why is there darkness? If this is the will of God, why is it I have no light at this time? Don't be a child, be mature. It says, once you are sure, I'm in the will of God. I fear the Lord. Obeying the voice of his servant. And although I do that, I'm still in darkness. I can't see light. It says, at such a time, trust in the name of the Lord. Don't say, no, I want to go to where there is light. I want to go to where there is a light. That light may be kindled by the devil, don't you know?
Just
trust in the Lord your God.
Stay
upon God. I know one thing. I know I'm in the will of God. I know there is darkness now, but it's the will of God. It's like I can't see ahead now, but it's the will of God. It's like the future is gloomy and bleak, but I know it's the will of God. It's like this thing that I'm doing, I know it's the will of God, but I can't understand. It's like I can't see God at the end of the tunnel. Brother, sister, stay there.
It's
the will of God. Don't run away from that thing.
It's
the will of God. Don't abandon that thing. It's the will of God. You may not see a light, but it's the will of God. Always remember that it is better for you to dwell in the dark with Christ Jesus than to dwell in the light of your own making. You will not find fulfillment in that kind of place.
Oh, niri mo se niru
rube. You know there are some of you over there.
Eh,
you
can
yes, you are in the will of God. But maybe there is a problem in your life.
Wala kan wa
a difficulty in your life. And some people are telling you. Are you going to remain there?
Sebe na lo duro
si. This thing is the will of God. Why is the problem there?
To ba je fi Olorun lo lo wa nu re. E se to fi ni wahala.
This thing is the will of God. Why are you in that difficulty?
Ti o ba je fi Olorun, e se ti soro fi wa.
If this way is the will of God, why are you following that way? You having that difficulty?
Yo ne ba je fi Olorun.
And you tell them, I may not see light, but I know there is God here. I may not see ahead, but I know I'm in the will of God. And they may be trying to pull you.
Say,
come to this place. Go to that other place. Follow to that other place. There's another group there. Another light there. Another revelation somewhere. Come to that place of revelation. Come to light. And that light may not be the light of God. You may not see
life,
but if you are sure this is the will of God, that's where your faith is necessary. And you say, I know it's the light. I know the Lord is there. And I don't care whether I can see that light. I'm going to stay in that will of God. You know, this narrow way to heaven is the way to heaven. This narrow path, it may be filled with thorns, may be filled with briars, may be filled with tough times, may be filled with difficulties. I know it's the will of God. I know it's the way of the cross. I know it's the way that leads home. And I'm going to stand fast in that way. I'm not going to waver or falter or fall out of the way. I stay in that way. And I'm calling you, church, this morning. I say, you want relationship with the Lord? Come back to the center of the will of God. You want revelation from the Lord? Come back to the center of the will of God. You want divine favor from God? Come back to the center of the will of God. You want to respond to your prayer when you pray? Come back to the response to the center of the will of God. People that are pulling you by the periphery, they want to pull you out of the will of God. Go away out of the center of the will of God. Stay there. God will meet you there. And when he meets you there, he takes your hand and he's taking you to fulfillment.
Thy
will be done. Not my will. Not the will of my friend. Not the will of my pastor. Not the will of my husband. Not the will of my wife. Not even the will of my leader. But Lord, thy will be done. Thy will be done. That's a part of fulfillment. That's a prayer you ought to pray. The long time you pray that prayer lasts in your life. That's the plan, the prayer God is calling you to. If you continue in the will of God, and I can tell you, remaining in this Bible church is the will of God. The church that tells you how to make heaven. The church that tells you the truth of the word of God. The church that tells you without holiness no man shall see the Lord. The church that gives you balanced truth that will take you to heaven. The church that does not keep quiet when you sin. The church that will not be palliating wickedness. The church that will love you in spite of your problems. I think that's the will of God.
And
if you allow anything or anybody to swerve you out of this will of God, remember, outside the will of God, there is no joy. Outside the will of God, there is no life. Outside the will of God, there is no answer to prayer. But in the will of God, all things are yours. All things are yours. And today, all things are yours. You will do the will of God. I know you will do the will of God. You will not do your own will. You will not do the will of the devil. I know and I trust. By the grace of God, you will do the will of God. I want you to rise up and promise the Lord, I will do the will of God. In my life, I will not do my own will. I will not follow my own way. I will not walk in my own path. The will of God only. The will of God alone. That's what I will do. I will not do the will of a friend. I will not do the will of my father. I will not do the will of an enemy. Only the will of God. Will of God only. Will of God only. That's the way of God. Remember that if you don't do the will of God, heaven cannot be sure. And if you are a sinner here, salvation is the will of God. Salvation is the will of God. You must be saved. You can be saved. You must be saved. If you are not saved, you are not in the will of God. If you are still living in sin, you are not in the will of God. If you are still living in your bad habits, you are not in the will of God. What is the will of God? But this is the will of God, that you are saved, that you are sanctified. It's the will of God that you know the truth of the word of God. Sinner friend, confess your sins to the Lord, pray to him, get salvation. That is the will of God. My dear brother, sister, you have started following your own will. You say, I don't think I can follow that will. That will of God is too slow for me. That will of God, it's too slow for me. I want to do my own will. I want to follow my own way. Don't do that. There's danger ahead of that. Come back to the will of God. Come back to the will of God. My dear brothers and sisters, come back to the will of God. There are some that are living the center of the will of God. Come back. Come back to that will of God. Sanctification is the will of God. Blameless conduct is the will of God. Obedience at all times is the will of God. Praising God in all difficulties is the will of God. If your heart is the will of God. Marrying is the will of God, that's the will of God. Seeking God before you take a decision, that's the will of God. There may be darkness, but follow it, that's the will of God. If you look as if you cannot see ahead, but that's the will of God. They might be pulling you here and there, but that's the will of God. Other people, they may say, come to our church, but this is the will of God. If you desire anything above the holiness message, you are living the will of God. If you desire anything outside the sanctification message, you are living the will of God. Will of God. That is what you must do. If you are a sinner here, pray and get saved. Repent of your sin. Tell the Lord, I'm a sinner. Forgive me. I don't want to die in my sin. I want you to really fulfill your will in my life. I know it's your will for me to be saved. No matter the sin I have committed, I know you are willing to save me.